Gym battles are one of the most important things to do in Pokemon Scarlet and Violet. They help you unlock higher level Pokemon to obey you and make it easier to catch those higher level Pokemon as you complete them. And they also give you access to unlock multiple items in the Pokemon shops as you're continuing through your game. So the more you do, the more stuff you get, the more better Pokemon you can catch. Basically, it works like this. If you beat one gym, you get up to level 25, 230, 335, 440, 545, 650, 7 level 55, and once you beat the 8th gym, you can get any Pokemon to listen to you no matter what. So you don't want to run into the mistake of not beating a gym, your friend sending over a really powerful Pokemon to you, and then it just doesn't listen to you in battle. There are also three very important things to note about these gyms. Number one, after every gym match, the gym leader will be giving you a TM of the signature move they use during the battle. Number two, after you beat the 5th gym, you will be able to get Terra Blast, which is really important because it allows you to get a free stab move with whatever Terra type you turn into. After the 6th gym battle, Jacques, one of the teachers in the game, will be giving you the Lucky Egg after the 6th one. This Lucky Egg is going to help give more experience to your Pokemon as you're going throughout the game. Now, there are some simple strategies that people do. Some people just like to overlevel their starter and nuke every single gym. If you're one of those people, you can do that. But stick around to see exactly what these Pokemon you're going to be facing are going to be. And for those who want to enjoy Pokemon and take it a little bit slower with a little more strategy and thinking about it, I'm going to be doing a breakdown of all the gym leaders. So let's hit the first one. The Bug Gym Leader, Kathy. You can find this gym in Portundo Town. This is the first one. It's the weakest gym out of all of them. You're first going to have to do this really weird challenge where you roll a seed into a goalpost, and after that, you're going to take her on. Her team is going to consist of Nimble, which is level 14, Tarantula, which is level 14, and Teddy Ursa, which is level 15. This is going to be the bug type, and all gym leaders will have their last Pokemon Terra type on you to completely change things up. So the Pokemon that you don't want to bring to this fight are going to be grass Pokemon, psychic Pokemon, and dark Pokemon, as they won't be doing as well against them. Basically, if you pick the starter cat, this is not the gym battle for Sprigatito. If you have a fire type, a flying type, or a rock type, these are going to be very good for this gym. Since this is the easiest gym, the Teddy Ursa, that's a normal type that transforms into a bug type, shouldn't give you any bit of a challenge. If you're Team Fight Coco, you pretty much have this gym in a wrap. You can grab Pokemon like Rockruff, which is a rock Pokemon that can destroy these, Talonflame Evolution Line, and anyone that you may think of that is super effective against bug. Once you beat the fight, Kathy is going to give you TM21, which is Pounce. The next level difficulty gym is going to be the grass one, which is located in Artazone. You're basically going to be fighting Brassius here, and the challenge before that is going to just be finding 10 some flora, and then you're on to Brassius. Now, Brassius Pokemon are going to be Petalil at level 16, Smoliv at level 16, and Sudowoodo at level 17. When it comes to these grass Pokemon, you don't want to bring a water type, a ground type, or a rock type. Really good typings that can destroy grass Pokemon are fire, ice, poison, flying, and bug. These are super effective against grass, so I highly suggest bringing Pokemon of these type to this fight. Now, any fire Pokemon can be good for the first two fights, like a Fuecoco or a Talonflame, but the problem is, once you reach Sudowoodo, because it's originally a rock type and now it becomes a grass Terra type, it has access to use rock moves on you and destroy you. So be careful when you're using flying types or rock types. If Sudowoodo's faster, it will knock you out. If you outspeed Sudowoodo or slightly leveled above it and you have higher speed, you should be able to easily win this fight. Also, most of these gym fights are very easily winnable in the early stages because they have about 3 Pokemon. After you defeat Brassius, he'll give you TMO20, which is Trailblaze. Trailblaze is that move Sudowoodo was using to speed up and hit you, so it's pretty cool to have that, and you can use this on your Pokemon. Speaking of all these Pokemon, you should definitely subscribe so we can catch all these dragon Pokemon. The next level of gym difficulty will be in Lavincia. This is going to be against the gym leader, Iono. The gym challenge before Iono is going to be finding where Clavel is, and then it's going to be random fights against guys, and then finally get to fight Iono, who is really fun to beat. Iono's team is going to consist of Wattrel at level 23. This is a flying electric type. Luxio, which is just pure electric type, at level 23. Belly Bolt, electric type, which knows water moves, at level 23. And Miss Magius, which is a ghost type that becomes a Terra electric type. The best team I would use in this fight is going to be Paldean Wooper slash Claude Sire's evolution, because it can eat water attacks if it has the ability Water Absorb. So Belly Butt will do nothing against it, which means you're just gonna get free health for absolutely no reason. You can destroy almost all these Pokemon with ground attacks. The Water Roll that's flying can be hit with a Rock Tomb TM, So that's pretty useful if you do have that. And when it comes to Miss Magius, if she happens to use a grass attack on you, you're pretty safe because the Wooper will take normal damage against it and will not take super effective damage. And Wooper can easily clap that Pokemon with a ground attack. So ground type Pokemon, really powerful for this one, and Paldean Wooper line is going to take the win on this one. After you beat Iono, she's going to give you TM048, which is Vault Switch. Vault Switch is going to be very useful TM on your journey in this game, as you can just get a free electric move on a Pokemon, hit them, and switch out. The next gym leader is going to be Kofu, which is located in Kaskarafa Gym. This is the water town. He's a water gym leader, and the mini game is basically giving him his wallet and then doing an auction. Really strange one. Kofu's team is basically going to consist of Veluza, which is a water psychic type fish. This is a new one. Wugtrio, which is a mono water type. And Crabominable, which is a fighting ice type that Terra transforms into water type. Crabominable is probably the biggest threat here. Now, I would suggest easily bringing an electric Pokemon. Electric Pokemon would do phenomenal against this gym. You can knock out Veluza, you can knock down Wugtrio, but Crabominable is going to be a little more difficult because grass type Pokemon, if you were to bring one, would get easily nuked by an ice attack. Electric Pokemon would be the way to go, outspeeding Crabominable. Crabominable is a very bulky defensive type, so if you do have a special attack Pokemon that is bulky, maybe a Raichu, maybe a Pikachu with a Eviolite, things like that would be very useful, or any other electric Pokemon that you may think of. Once you clear out the Crabominable, Kofu is going to give you TM22, which is Chilling Water after the fight. Chilling Water is a pretty cool move that you can use. The next level of difficulty is the Medali gym leader, Larry. This one is really big. Basically, the gym test is figuring out what a secret recipe is by battling a couple of trainers, and then you're going to hit this fight with Larry. Larry's going to have Komala, the Dunsparce, which is the evolution of Dunsparce, and Staraptor. Now, these are all normal typings here. So the first instinct is simply just bring a fighting type. Fighting types can do a nasty job and destroy most of these Pokemon here. Komala's gonna get wrecked. The Dunsparce is gonna get wrecked. And Staraptor is going to lose its flying type to just be pure normal type. What this means is that if Staraptor outspeeds your fighting Pokemon, it is going to be able to still use its flying moves and wreck you. It's gonna lose its weakness against anything like electric, ice, rocks, anything that would normally take it down. So the only super effective move would have to be a fighting move. This means basically bring any non-fighting Pokemon that has access to fighting moves. Gengar is a really good option because Gengar can't really be hit by normal moves, and Gengar can also learn some fighting special moves via TM. If you have any Pokemon you want to mention for this one, let me know. Larry's going to give you TM25, Bacade, after the fight. The next one is the Ghost Gym. This one's a little bit different. You're going to be doing these warm-up fights via pre-battle, and this is going to be the doubles battle gym. Now, Ryme's team is very cool. She leads off with Mimikyu, level 41, Ghost Fairy type, Banette, Ghost type. So those are the first ones out on the field, then followed up by Houndstone, which is a pure Ghost type, and then a Toxtricity, which is an electric poison type that becomes Ghost type. So the best case scenario is to maybe bring out a Steel or Poison Pokemon to deal with the Mimikyu threat that is on the field. Tinkaton is a really good option to take care of the Mimikyu. Tinkaton also has access to dark moves as well. Leading also, you'd want to bring a dark Pokemon. So maybe a Sableye, a Grimmsnarl, anything that you can really think of. But Tinkatunk is going to do the job. Mimikyu could be really annoying if you just brought a pure dark type to this. So once you take care of all these Pokemon, it should be a joke. Toxtricity didn't seem like much of a problem because it became ghost type. So don't bring any fairy types. If you bring a Gardevoir, Toxtricity can obviously take it out by using electric or poison types. Once you beat Ryan, she's going to give you TM114, which is Shadow Ball. Very powerful special attack move that you can use on your Pokemon team. The next gym in level of difficulty is going to be the Psychic Gym Leader, Tulip. This is a very strange pre-gym challenge beforehand. You're doing these weird emotion matching games where you're just like expressing your Pokemon in their face, and then you're battling trainers after every round. I think these are the strangest things. But once you do that, you move on to the gym match, and Tulip's team is going to be Ferrigarath at level 44, Espartha at level 44, Gardevoir at level 44, and a Florgis at level 45, which is a fairy type that's going to terraform into a psychic type. It hasn't been obvious. Their last Pokemon always becomes psychic, but it's not going to be originally a psychic type, which makes it difficult because they have access to other moves. Pokemon that you would want to bring, since they're super effective against psychics, are going to be bug, ghost, or dark Pokemon. What you want to avoid is bringing any fighting Pokemon or poison Pokemon to this fight, since psychic is super effective against that. To deal with this, a good time to show off one of the new Pokemon, I would say low kicks would do a very good job here since it's a bug psychic type. It should have no problem taking out the Ferrigraph and Esparta. Gardevoir, if you would like to bring a poison type, it could do the damage, or I suggest just bringing a steel Pokemon to take out the Gardevoir. And then Florigus is finally a fairy type that goes to psychic, so it's going to be using fairy moves. So if you want to stay kind of neutral, you could have a steel type Pokemon still be there to not take the damage from the fairy moves that Florigus will throw at you. Otherwise, if it's a psychic type, you can just hit it hard with a dark type. But you have to be aware that Florigus can use its fairy attacks and destroy your dark Pokemon. So be wise about what you're doing and if you're going to outspeed that Pokemon, or if you just want to have a neutral battle with that Florigus. Let me know your options that you think that would work on this team. This should also be a great gym to have Sprigatito fight. After you're done with the fight, Tulip will give you TM120, which is going to be psychic. Who saw that coming? After this fight. Now, the hardest gym battle in the game by level is going to be Grusha of the Glassy Auto Gym. This is going to have a mini game where you're just skiing down a mountain and then you're going to be challenging Grusha. He is a very interesting gym leader. Since it's an ice type gym, Grusha has the advantage against grass Pokemon, ground Pokemon, flying Pokemon, and dragon Pokemon. And with Grusha's last Pokemon being Altaria and it's still knowing fairy moves, it puts you at a threat of you can't really even bring dark or fighting Pokemon to this fight since that Altaria will absolutely nuke them. Frostmoth is going to be at level 47, which is an ice bug type, easily nukable by having a fire type Pokemon on your team. Beartrick, very dangerous. This Pokemon can attack your fire Pokemon with ground typings and rock type attacks, so be aware of that. Titan, also very powerful Pokemon that has access to moves outside of just ice type. But if you're fast enough and hit them with fire types, these three Pokemon should go down easily. Then Altaria comes out, which is going to be terrestrialized into an ice type, making Altaria a little dangerous since it has crazy coverage and now it has the ice defense. Like I said, fighting can't be used against this Altaria because Altaria is going to have fairy moves. Unless you can outspeed and hit this Altaria really fast, you're going to lose if you cannot outspeed it. I stuck with using Fuecoco's third evolution for this fight because it was a fire ghost type and was able to do some significant damage against these Pokemon. So I'd suggest bringing multiple fire types and you should be able to get through this fight with no problem. After you're done with the fight, Grusha is going to give you TM124, which is Ice Spinner, and you can use that on your team. Now you know all the gym fights, but you also need to know how to beat the Titan Pokemon in the game. So go ahead and click on this video here to see the full guide on how to beat all the Titan Pokemon.